U.S. Air Force's Agility Prime program, electric vertical takeoff and landing aircraft, flying car. The Air Force is on track to buy and start fielding its first electric vertical takeoff and landing aircraft that could carry passengers or cargo under the Agility Prime program in 2023. This year, the service is bringing these flying cars to more exercises and demonstrations as it gets airmen and the public used to the concept. The Air Force's proposed fiscal 2023 budget asked for $3.6 million in Agility Prime's first procurement funds, which it would use to buy five of the eVTOL aircraft. Lieutenant Colonel John Tekell, who runs the Agility Prime program, said that the initial procurement will come next year, with more selections will likely follow. The Air Force is looking at 66 potential uses for Agility Prime, including the possibility of using it to infiltrate and exfiltrate special operations troops and rescuing downed aviators or other personnel in enemy territory where conditions might be too dangerous to send in a traditional helicopter. Agility Prime's first real-world uses will likely be by supporting test and training ranges, as well as other cargo transportation tasks, though it could eventually end up playing a role in a major war. The Air Force is particularly interested in how Agility Prime could help the service rapidly set up bases in a conflict zone as part of its agile combat employment concept, especially if facilities have been seriously damaged in an attack and need to be quickly re-established nearby. In the past, the Air Force might have had to resort to traditional helicopters or tilt-rotor aircraft to move equipment or supplies around when roads or other infrastructure were unusable. Agility Prime's electric vertical takeoff and landing capability can get that job done in a simpler, much more fuel-efficient way. And it would be much cheaper than a traditional helicopter, Tekell said. It remains to be seen what the final price tags for Agility Prime might be, and the Air Force is still discussing procurement costs with firms. It could range anywhere from $3 million to $5 million apiece. This isn't something we're going to replace legacy assets with. This is something you use in conjunction with legacy assets to make your operations significantly more efficient. The Air Force's tests of Agility Prime last year, including a demonstration last March that showed lift aircraft's hexa platform could fit and be safely transported in a military cargo plane, were successful, Tekell said. And this year, Agility Prime's aircraft out in the public so more airmen can see it in action and prove they're capable and safe. This will be an important step towards getting Agility Prime viewed as an accepted, everyday part of the U.S. Air Force's fleet. Thank you for watching. Please like, share, comment, and subscribe.